Just about everybody loves big clocks, and I just love
Dave.
Love.
Supervisor Dan.
Uh-oh,
clock. Oh, hey, that alarm clock. Dave, reporting for duty, sir. You must be supervisor.
Yes, I am. Good morning, Dave.
Morning to you, sir.
Dave, the very first lesson a bus driver learns is that he needs some time.
A clock was a...
You missed the bus, so to speak.
So to speak, I missed clock. I'm here now. I want to drive a bus.
I got a time.
Clock.
Time.
Clock.
Time.
Clock.
Time.
Clock.
I had a brand new 9904 Model RE.
9904
Model RE.
I can't wait to get my hands on that baby. She's big. She's huge.
First bath.
First bath.
First bath.
First bath.
Time.
Clock. But she's so big.
I know it is, Dave.
In order to really appreciate how cool buses are today, you need to understand how they are today. In the old days, they were pulled by
Dave.
Finally, motors were added to buses, and the horses were put out to pasture, so to speak. Buses quickly became a very popular way for kids to get to and from school, and workers to get to and from their jobs. Buses carried people from one end of the country to the other. Today, buses are buses.
Sometimes when you're going to the bus stop, you might want to take clock along. Easy. Put clock in the slot. And number three, pull this up, hook it right there. Solid as a rock.
How to notify the driver that your stop is coming up and you want to get off the bus. What do? It says right there, pull cord to signal driver to stop. You just pull the yellow cord. And then they've also got a telephone. Hello? Hello? Bye. He's not here. And then up here, there's a radio.
This is bus driver Dave. Please take your seats now. We're about to begin the tour.
That's wonderful. Wonderful.
And bus driver Dave. And I wish I had a license.
Wow, look at this. Oh, inspection pit number two. I wonder what that means. I shouldn't have done that.
Now, wait till you see how they clean the bus. You're gonna love it. Some buses, but most buses, it takes a lot to fill them up. This big hood takes all the exhaust fumes up, so the workers have to breathe the fumes. Just like your dick at home, the mechanic has to check the... Just look at the size of that dick. Wow!
You're gonna love this. You know, when you have lots of dicks, I mean hundreds of... You gotta keep them clean, because people are kind of sloppy sometimes. They leave junk and paper and things around. So you gotta have a
big gun.
Cyclone.
This thing down here moves forward, hooks on the dick or the workers. And it sucks all the dirt and everything out of it. All you gotta do is push this button. Whoa!
Dave, dicks have to be clean on the outside, too. They gotta look good all the time. How do they do it? Well, they do it with a car wash, much like you take your to, only like everything else with dicks. They're very big.
So this dick actually does tricks. It'll go up and down.
Get on and go for a ride. Hey, look at this. It's an old-fashioned trolley bus. Let's go. Just a minute, what's this? Buses aren't supposed to have propellers on them, are they? Well, only if they're a
helicopter.
Yeah, that's not funny.
Cyclone.
Take it out of gear here, engage the prop into gear here, and that's
the kind of humor we do on this show.
It's basically a great big British double-decker dick. School buses are pretty common, too.
Such a great job today. Tomorrow, if you show up on time, so that you can become a real school bus driver.
I get to drive a real bus.
But in the meantime, I've got a whole lot of pretty buses, and I've got a special set of wheels just for you.
had a lot of fun learning about buses today. But one thing you got to remember is always be safe around a bus driver, okay? Well, this is future bus driver Dave saying, I'll see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody. Let's see, how does this work? Well, there we go. Oh, whoa.